Welcome to Off the Press, the program where we take a look at the national dailies, as you do know, and try to make sense of it and dissect it. And with me to do so this morning is Moses Nnaekpe, who's a public affairs analyst, and still with me is Ugochukwu Ikeakor. Good to have you both. Good morning, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Good to have you, and Happy New Year. We've not seen it since the beginning of this year.
Same to you.
So it's good to see you. All right, let's go straight to the business. We have a couple of papers this morning, Vanguard, The Nation, Punch, and we'll take them one after the other, but we shall begin with the Vanguard this morning. And it says, Miete Allah to Southwest, dump Amotekun or lose 2023 presidency. You can see it there on the front page as displayed on your screens. It says it will be used against innocent herders. It's Nnamdi Kanu's wing in Southwest. To hell with their presidency, according to Afenifere. They should go to blazes. Wow, very strong words this morning. That story is on page 5 of the Vanguard newspaper. Let's go to the top of the newspaper. Also, court declares compulsory retirement of Colonel Arigbe wrongful, illegal, and void on page 40. And Imo S. Governor's proof, Okoracha Ihedioha De Uzodima on page 15. Ibadan monarchs sue Makinde, Ladoja, others over nullification of crowns. Interesting story there on page 10. And English-speaking West African countries reject adoption of ECO by Francophone countries. That story is on page 9 of the Vanguard newspaper, so you can see already displayed there on your screens. And to the right, alleged bias, Oshomole petitions reverse a CJ 6 transfer of case on page 12. And then installation of Mayegun, no comparison between Alaafin Are on Akakamfo's chief. That's according to Are Adams on page 11. And that will be it on the Vanguard newspaper. Oh, sorry, there's something I missed out at the top there. It says blackout as TCN, that's transmission company, right, suffers first system collapse in 2020. I'm sure most of you would have experienced power outages today. So where do we begin this morning? I should start with you from my left.
Well, let's begin with the Miete Allah issue. The dump Amotekun or lose 2020 presidency. It's funny.
Because, is it?
Yeah, it's very funny because these people think they own this country.
Which people?
The Miete Allah. Over time, they have this track record of making bogus statements and they go squatry. You know, how can you tell the Southwest that if they don't drop Amotekun, they are going to lose the presidency? Number one, what they are doing is legal. They are not doing anything illegal. So what?
So I need to clarify which people.
What I'm talking about Amotekun now, the Southwest. What the Southwest are doing is legal. It's constitutional.
You didn't hear the AGF saying it's illegal?
Well, he quoted section 227. And this Amotekun is not set up for political reasons. It's set up to complement security outfits. Like, we have HISBA in the north. We have the JTF,
task force.
Yes, civilian task force, and nobody's saying anything about it. So why are they crying foul when it comes to other region? I don't think these people are. They think they own this country, and they need to be put where they belong. This is a federal system, and every state have the right to do what is good for their people. And the earlier they know that, the better for them. It's only the people. That is why we still need to come to having a vibrant electoral system where we can elect our leaders ourselves. If we don't do that, these people will keep determining who becomes president and who doesn't become president.
What are your thoughts, Ugochukwu?
Well, I think Miete Allah just that inconsequential in the grand scheme of things. And that is like the footnote, you know, when you have a thesis. So for me, they're not important. And the truth is that I want to say this thing now, like 2023, I think the two presidential, the two political parties at that time were few candidates from the north. Mm-hmm. And that is the truth. They find someone from the Southwest societies to complement it. But that aside, but for Miete Allah, they're not to be taken serious. You can't tell a Southwest, you can't tell a state, you can't tell the people what to do. And the fact is that because sometimes we make people that are supposed to be footnote in history, we give them relevance. Why are they on the front page? Who are they? They have nothing to, if they do things that is contrary, the state take them up. But we've seen that sometimes, over lately, the state has emboldened them to say something that they're seeing which doesn't make sense. And I think that is wrong. Nobody should pay them attention. The Southwest should go on, like what he said, in addition to what he said, it is something that is important. It is a conversation that we must have, because the internal security architecture of this our country is failing every day. Mm-hmm. And it's not a bad thing for state to say, okay, together as one, we want to put this thing together. Nigeria, we have a federal system of government in code, but we don't have federalism in practice. this. So it's conversations like this that will push us to that place where federalism, where actual governance start coming in place. Because if Southwest people are saying they will do this, they will own it. It becomes their own. The payment, the grading and everything, and it helps at the end of the day. So it's not about, Mieti Ala cannot determine who will be the president of Nigeria in 2023. So it doesn't have basis. So, and also for Nnamdi Kanu, I think it would be nice now, I didn't say it earlier during the news, that for Southwest people to try as much as possible to distance himself from this. Already you can see what Mieti Ala is doing. They're trying to paint Amoteku to be like a branch of Nnamdi Kanu in the Southwest. So what it does is that over there in the up north, they start seeing it as something that they're trying to do something that's similar. That is what is happening. Whereas there are two different conversations. And that's why I tell you that maybe, but that's why I said earlier, I think they've had this conversation with the president. But when they went back, when they launched it, some people within the presidency now went back and told them, this is not what we thought it was supposed to be. And Mieti Ala feeding into that Nnamdi Kanu narrative, and Nnamdi Kanu coming out to come and say, okay, I'll give you 1 million soldiers. I think there is something fishy between Mieti Ala and Nnamdi Kanu. That is a connection that a lot of people need to explore.
Does he even have a million foot soldiers, would agree?
It's not about agreeing, it's about perception. What is he saying? Because nobody's going to come out and do anything for him. So at the end of the day, whenever he keeps bringing up this perception, it makes a mess of the conversation, right? Because there is no part of what Nnamdi, so because he's somebody that a lot of people listen to when he says the people pick it. So he models up the conversation. Mieti Ala is already saying, is already painting this to be like a branch of Nnamdi Kanu in the Southwest, which is not true. And already Nnamdi Kanu is saying that I'm going to give you 1 million soldiers. I will know how Nnamdi Kanu left this country. Right, so which is still another issue. So at the end of the day, both of them are not supposed to have any say in this conversation. This is what Southwestern people want. This is what the governors do. And the governors are doing it because the people that elected them are saying, this is what we want at this point in our state. So it's a good conversation. It's something that is right. The AGF is speaking because he's working in a unitary, he's working in a government that has a unitary mindset that cannot harbor conversation around negotiation. Renegotiation and trying to push our country forward.
I think it's an important point you're making there, especially when you say to stick to the conversation and let's not digress, because there seem to be elements of digressing and shifting the whole conversation. All right, there are other stories here on the Vanguard newspaper. English-speaking West African countries reject adoption of ECO, Imo ex-governors. You're from Imo, by the way.
No problem, number.
Oh, okay. I take that back. I thought so. All right, so what else is... Do you want to intervene, Ugochukwu, on any of the stories still here on the front page of the Vanguard newspaper? Alleged bias, Oshomole petitions Rivers. We have Imo governor's probe. Okoracha Ihedio Hade Uzodima, court declares compulsory retirement of Colonel Aribe Rumfu, illegal void. And blackout at CCN suffers first system collapse in 2020. Who else experienced that?
Yeah, it was
yesterday. Mine is not even back. I mean, I don't know what
mine
I should
is
say.
Back. That was yesterday.
Oh, wow.
So,
okay.
So I think it's part of the issue that we keep having. In terms of last year, I think we had like nine, it happened nine times or so.
This is just the beginning of the year. The 17th day of the year.
So it's going to be a long year for us. And like I always say, what we had, the 4,000 megawatt or whatever we generate at this point,
that's what was generated, in fact, yesterday.
It does not help us, right? There's no way we can make progress as a country if we don't start at this point, start exploring other alternative sources of energy and start having this conversation, because we keep having this issue. And the fact is that, let's see, but we don't have a government that is responsible in trying to have this conversation, trying to see how we can push power. But we keep having this issue, and as far as we keep having this issue, it will keep affecting drastically our economic output and what we'll do, because a lot of people that would have done some work in terms of making money today wouldn't have been able to do it yesterday because there was no light. And it's not like everybody's rich in Nigeria to go and buy fuel and do every other thing and have a generator. So it's something that this is the conversation we want to have. Why is this thing happening? What is government doing about it? Not trying to outlaw something that is as important as Amoteku.
As long as the generation and transmission of power is still within the exclusive list of the federal government, we are going to be having all these issues. So they have to make every state, empower every state constitutionally to source for their own energy. When you do that, you will find out that all these things will fizzle out. As long as the federal government does the generation, they are in charge of distribution, they are in charge of so many things. So they need to allow the state governments, give them the power constitutionally to be able to source for their own power. And that will take care of all these things.
All right.
And this thing goes back to what we're saying about security, about economy. See, where we are as a country, we've tried everything. I don't think we'll even have a battery. We're running empty. Mm-hmm. So in terms of insecurity, in terms of economy, we need to start having this conversation. If that is the only way we can move this country forward, because the state has a lot of things in it, the federal government has a lot of things, and they're not doing it. Our power generation, economy, security. So if Southwest is same, that's why I say for me, this is like the most important thing that has happened since 2015. Not the election, right? Because we already know who will win at the end of the day when things started the way it started. But as now, we have a region saying this is what we want. So if this conversation continues and it gets, we start having a way where we can go to try and renegotiate and take some things that are not important in our constitution. Our constitution is not cast on stone. It can be renegotiated. Mm. We've seen it, some countries have done it in the past. In this country, we negotiated Bakassi and we gave it to Cameroon after 1999. So it's not a bad thing for people to say, okay, let's have this conversation. Let's take this out of the constitution so that the constitution can work better. The constitution, we made it the constitution. The constitution didn't make us. So if some things are not working in terms of security, I'm not taking what's supposed to happen. TCN, you've not, because if this thing works, state can generate power and give the federal government some. So and that is how you can do, that's how you can do it, and that's the commission we're supposed to have, not Mietiala coming to tell us 2023. Are they okay?
Yeah, we'll move forward and go to another newspaper in the interest of time. So we'll take the Nation newspaper, and it says Makinde betrayed us, say Ibadan, Obas, Ladoja and others sued on page 44, as you can see displayed there, of the Nation newspaper. And unfortunately, 9 burnt to death in Sagamu crash, and bandits killed 28 in Zamfara. Another case of insecurity, as you can see. Those stories you find on pages 5 and 44 of the Nation newspaper. 7.5% VAT takes off February the 1st, says Minister. AGF got it wrong. That story is on page 11. It's important that Nigerians know when that is taking effect. And Supreme Court's verdict on Ihedioha irreversible, says Agbakoba and others. That's on the front page, as you can see, but it's continued on page 8. And ex-Kwara Governor Ahmed left 7 months unpaid salaries on page 8. Fayemi, Amotekun aligns with Buhari's security vision. There is room for operational change. Talks on over controversy, says Akonde. That story, you can see it also on the front page. And it's continued on page 7 of the Nation newspaper. Alternative fuel at 97 naira per litre coming. PIB for passage in May. That's also on the front page. And then we have members of Nigeria Medical Association in Federal Capital yesterday protesting violence against health workers in Abuja. That's scary. So you can see a picture story of that. Stop violence against doctors. Please grab a copy and find out what that story is about. And Buhari tips Obiora for CBN Deputy Governor. Sanwo-Olu reshuffles ESCO. That's on page 11 and page 6 of the Nation newspaper. What's catching your attention?
The Supreme Court verdict.
Mm. It's irreversible, they say.
Well, I think there is room for the Supreme Court to... They can also reconsider their own judgment, but I don't think they will.
On what grounds do you think they can reconsider?
No. If they go back, it's only the Supreme Court that can do that. You know, they can reconsider. They can reverse their own judgment if they go back and find out that maybe they erred. You know, they can go back and then correct themselves. But I don't think they will have the political or the moral will to do this. But I don't really want to talk about this issue so much, because it's so appalling, because the judges are supposed to be very learned and intelligent people. Because if you look at the numbers, we had about 103,000 votes above the accredited votes. Mm-hmm. So it staggers my logical acumen how they could give a verdict that will have such a discrepancy. If you add 103 to any of the other candidates, it can change the dynamics of that judgment. So I wonder why the lordship did what they did. Well, there's nothing we can do. They say the Supreme Court is the final arbiter. So we'll just say it will go down in the history of jurisprudence in Nigeria, and it's a very, very bad omen for this country.
Hmm.
Well, for me, I've tried to not say on this thing because this is not the first. All right.
Say something on another thing.
Yeah, yeah, but, yeah. I think I'll go defy me. For me, what happened in Imo State and the judgment is not. It didn't just start today. All right. The day, remember that day that a lot of people were clapping their hands, celebrating in this country that they raided judges' houses at night.
Mm-hmm.
It is wrong. But you know, sometimes what happens to us is that sometimes we operate in the realm of emotions in Nigeria. People are not very logical when it doesn't make sense. And the way they removed the CJN, mm-hmm. right, it wasn't logical. So if what is happening up to this moment is an abuse of the judicial process and jurisprudence and everything we have in this country. Who started it? Who allowed it? I don't know how long it's going to take.
How did we get to this point?
We got to this point the moment people brought in politics into judgment. All right, people felt that it was okay to do something, maybe because we were trying to bring down corruption and the rest of them. No, all right, the law is the law, and if the independent at the moment, I don't think the Nigerian judiciary is independent of anything.
They are not.
All right, their body language, whatever they say, is what Aso Rock wants to say, and that is the truth. All right, this judgment has the seal of Aso Rock, not the seal of judiciary. And if the chief CJN can say, then I can argue with him any place. All right, this does not. All right, even his own colleagues, his members, and his people they are still surprised. So for me that is a layman, I can tell you that this is wrong. So it doesn't make sense. And for Fayemi is a smart governor, but he's trying to lie to himself on this issue. Buhari is not keen. Amoteku does not align with Buhari's vision. Because Buhari's security vision for him wants to be unitary, all right? The truth is that you see, Southwest governor needs to start telling people the truth of what is on the ground, all right? The president does not have a shared ideology with the Southwest at this point. It is clear, because if he does have a shared ideology, it will make easy. You have a VP that is from the Southwest. So it's supposed to be easy for them to get things done. It does not have a shared ideology. And Fire Minister acknowledge that and tell his people, you can't just lie to your people when the presidency is lying to you. It doesn't make sense.
We shall proceed in the interest of time.
Quickly, what Fire Minister is saying is that Omotekun is in line with the president's vision of a safe country. That's what he's just trying to say.
He's affirming that Omotekun
is not a threat to the security of Nigeria.
Yeah, but Ugochukwu is giving a different interpretation.
That's what I'm saying. That's what Fayemi is trying to say. He's saying that Omotekun is okay for Nigeria.
We shall proceed in the interest of time to the Guardian newspaper, which basically has, again, the same story. On the front page, resign now, PDP tells CJN. That story is on the front page. The National Security Agency is backed, Amotekun says Fayemi. IPOB and others declare support, urge federal government to review their stance. That is on the front page, as displayed and continued on page 6. And Buhari pledges sustained efforts to end child marriage. Nigeria outlines 9 focal areas to guide 4-year foreign policy on page 3. And NSCDC arrests lady for attempting to lure 4 girls to Mali for prostitution on page 34, and 9 burnt to death, unfortunately, bus explosion. That story is also on page 35. We'll just take one story here in the interest of time. Yeah, what about it?
It's funny, because
I find very serious things funny to you.
No,
is it weird?
No, yeah, you know why I say it's funny? Because we have seen some states in this country pass legislations that allow underage girls to get married based on their religion.
Mm-hmm. So the president is seen differently.
No,
so
it's not. They are just paying lip service. Their religion allows them to marry underage girls. So, and there are some states that have even passed these laws. So it is. He can't do anything about it. He cannot do anything. That one is just propaganda.
Let's hear it unfold.
He can't do anything about it.
There's something else about the PDP saying that the CJN should resign.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, PDP. She's not going anywhere. He's going to be there as long as they want him to be there, right? And the PDP has failed to act as an opposition party. PDP has failed to caution the governors and imprison journalists across the country, from the governor of Cross River and the governor of Akwa Ibom State. You have no moral right. Right, you've not kept your house in order. All right, some of us voted for this party. Some of us done some things for this party in the past and everything. But at this point, if you cannot be demanding something that you cannot give. All right, when was last time secondaries came out to tell the governor, what's his name, the kinetic guy? I always have this big Ayade.
Ben Ayade, professor.
When did he come out? Has he come out to tell him to stop imprisoning journalists that ask questions about actual governance? Has he done that? No. Yeah, he's making a solid claim, but the thing that the Supreme Court has passed a judgment, and the Supreme Court, like you say, cannot revoke the judgment. So what we need is for PDP to actually do the work of opposition in this country. They are not doing it. They are buying time for 2023. They are not doing it. And because they are not doing it, a lot of things will keep going wrong. And also, they should call their governors in order, starting with Ayade and Odom Emmanuel. You can't have governors imprison journalists, imprison private citizens because they criticize you on Facebook or Instagram or wherever.
In a democratic
in a democratic setting. And you are calling yourself the opposition. Party, they should be ashamed of themselves. From secondary to the like gate man in PDP or Data Plaza Abuja.
Wow, gate man, Data Plaza. Okay, so we'll take the last paper and we'll just read out the headlines in the interest of time. An NBA false AGFs, Fire Minister Security Agencies partnered governors on Amotekun on page 2 of the Punch newspaper. Again, Buhari flies to UK, begins a 6-day trip today. That's on page 36. Supreme Court heavily compromised, has lost credibility. PDP says so on page 14. And Zamfara bandits kill 31 in fresh attacks and steal food on page 2, and we see the workers the NBA strike action also on the front page. NMA protest attack on medical personnel, that's on page 39. Sonwolu drops commissioner, appoints 3 others on page 41, and Abdulrazak vows to sanction principal over exam malpractices on page 4. Investors lobby PFA suspension asset hit 9.8 trillion naira on page 29. Nigeria and Ghana, 4 others fought renaming of CFA Eco on page 25. Police launch manhunt for soldiers who killed women. Deceased sisters hired soldiers to fight neighbor. That story is on pages 4 and 5 of the Punch newspaper. And unfortunately, that's where we are going to wrap. I want to say thank you to Moses Naipe and thank you to Ugochukwu Ikako for coming.
Thanks for having us.
And sharing your thoughts. And we'll call it a wrap here on Plus TV Africa. I am Amaka Okoye. Have yourselves a great day.